Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Joe Broadway Road to the Show series here in MLB 15 The Show on the PS4. We are on episode 102 of the long-standing Joe Broadway series, and we don't plan on stopping anytime soon. We'll bring them into MLB 16 and beyond with those game saves that can transfer from year to year. We can definitely have a full career for Mr. Broadway. So, Broadway and the Cincinnati Reds are coasting along here in the month of September, looking to make the playoffs, looking to win their division, and are 79-52 entering this second game of a series at Wrigley Field against the Chicago Cubs. Here's a bouncer to third base. Broadway's going to throw over to first, and that is the end of that inning. So he goes and grabs a bat now in the top of the fourth. Cubs up 2-0. And this pitch is hit hard, but oh, Starlin Castro, good reflexes there at short, stabs that liner, and keeps Broadway off the base pass. Now, Cincinnati hitless into the seventh inning. We got a no-hitter going on. Broadway would like to wreck that right here. He's 0-2, and he gets his 1-1 pitch right back up the middle, and there you go, a no-hitter goes by the boards there, broken up by Joe Broadway, at least one hit on the day. Let's see if they can score some runs now and get back in this game, as that is a big relief off their shoulders. They do not score any runs. We go down 3-0 into the ninth, and oh, Broadway gets a hold of that one deep and gone. A Broadway bomb to left field. That is a milestone homer for the season, as it's number 40 for him. So another nice personal milestone with the two-run homer. They're not quite all the way back yet. It's 3-2, but it definitely puts some pressure on the Cubs here in the ninth as they're within striking distance. Broadway hit that one well to left and into the bleachers. So they don't get any closer. They lose this game 3-2. But Broadway with a couple hits late to make it interesting. So now that they've won the first game of the series, dropped the second, we'll see who wins the third and the series. But 40 home runs, the milestone for Broadway right there. Feels good to get that accomplished. And we do go to the third and deciding game of this three-game set. Let's play ball. 79-53, the record coming into today. Will today's game bring win number 80 on the season? Let's find out. 2-1 Cincinnati in the third. That's going to be rolled to short and should be a routine out. Broadway retired in that at bat. Let's go on to the sixth inning. We're tied at 3. 1-1 count, and Broadway's gonna smoke that down the left field line. It is played there by the left fielder, getting in quickly. So a solid single for Broadway, and maybe they can get something going to push the go-ahead run across here against the Cubs. 3-2 count with two outs means the runners can take off with the pitch, and they do. This one's hit solidly. Oh, it's off of Starlin Castro's glove and trickles into left field. Broadway will be able to score, and they do take the lead here 4-3. A little bit of a lucky play there as he could not stab that line drive. It's now 7-6 in the top of the ninth, runner at first, and that's past the second baseman and into the gap. That's going to roll all the way to the edge of the warning track. Runner coming around and should score. Insurance run there off the bat of Joe Broadway, an RBI double, and the Reds look like they are on their way to getting the victory today. Let's see how this thing ends up. Actually, the Cubs fight back and tie this thing. We have extra innings. We go into the top of the 12th now. 8-8 is your score. This one's rocketed to right field, but it's going to be tracked down out in the outfield. No hit for Broadway in that at bat. Will they be able to win this game? Well, we go to the bottom of the 12th. This is popped up. And behind third base, Broadway looking to make the play just inside fair territory. And the inning is over. The Reds looking to push home a run and win this game. And they do just that. They win this crazy long marathon game 9-8. So they'll be moving along from Wrigley Field with a series victory. They go through Milwaukee and win 2-3. And drop 2-3 in Pittsburgh. But this sets up a matchup with the next closest team in the division, the St. Louis Cardinals. They are 5 games back here, and it's a 4-game set. So this could really swing one way or another in somebody's favor. The Cardinals could sweep and make this a Very interesting division race, just a game behind the Reds, or the Reds could sweep, and this could extend to about 9 games. So this could really go one way or another and decide the division race. That is up the middle and a base hit for Joe Broadway. Got runners at first and second now as a result of that hit to center field. So a good start here for him swinging the bat. You get the bases loaded with nobody out in the third. And this pitch is a base hit up the middle. Zobrist comes through. One run will score. And the second run is also safe. The tag not in time. It is now a 4-0 lead for the Cincinnati Reds as Zobrist comes through. 9-1 now in the sixth inning. Running away with this. This is a pop foul and should be playable. And Broadway is retired right there. So he goes down in this at bat. A little frustrated that he hasn't contributed a little more in what was a runaway victory. There's lots of offense for the Reds, but it wasn't really coming off of Broadway's bat. He does go 1-for-5 and scores a run. And they win the game, which is the most important part here. So they take game one and extend to a 6-game lead in the division. How about game two? Well, St. Louis is serious about this one. They come flying out of the gates and take a 5-0 lead, and you got another pop-up here from Broadway in fair territory out on the outfield grass, and play is made right there by Matt Adams. Still 5-0, bottom of the sixth. There is a runner in scoring position, an 0-2 count. Ripped to center field. That's a base hit. That should bring home their first run of the game, and it does. So the Reds are at least on the board at 5-1 now, but they got a lot of work to do if they want to make a comeback. Let's see if they can get anywhere close in this, but first let's watch the replay as this is taken right back up the middle. Pitcher kind of flinches right there, but it's not even close to hitting him. Reds make it a little closer, 5-3 in the bottom of the eighth, the 1-1 count, and this one right back up the middle does hit the pitcher. Glances off there, third baseman tries to barehand it and can't make the play. That's going to be an infield hit, and you got to worry about the safety of your pitcher there, but he's fine. The Cardinals lock this one down. 5-3. The Reds came back a bit, but don't get it done. 2-for-4 for Broadway with an RBI. And there you go. They've split the first two games. So this pretty much ensures that St. Louis isn't going to get real close as a result of this series. But you still want to go ahead and at least split this thing and keep it at a 5-game lead. Let's see how game three goes as this is hit deep to right, and he can't make the play. Dove for it, but could not come up with it. Runner had to wait and see if that'd be caught. He scurries over to third base, and Joe Broadway has a double. So a nice job right there, just out of the reach of a diving right fielder. So it's 2-0 Cincinnati. Bottom of the second, he's up again. And same result to the gap in right center, and it's going to roll to the fence. This could bring home a run. He's coming around third and trying to score, and he will do just that. Broadway goes into third, and they almost throw it down the left field line. I almost came all the way around. 3-0 Cincinnati, bottom of the fifth, another at bat, and solid center field, the single, and Broadway's on for the third time this game. Two doubles and a single, and they cannot get him out right now. He goes 3-for-4 in the game, two doubles and that RBI, scoring a run himself, and the Reds win 4-2. So they're guaranteed at least a split against the Cardinals, and they've got that 6-game lead back. They actually take 3-of-4. And then they take the first game in San Francisco as well. They have a nice record too. But we got a winning streak going here. Let's go out to AT&T Park and check out the Reds, who are 30 games above 500 coming into play. We take you all the way to the top of the sixth. 1-1 game, and this is hit well the right field. But nice play ranging back there to make the catch and robbing Broadway of any notion of a hit right there. So he'll go back to the dugout and wait his turn. 4-3 Cincinnati in the ninth. How about a little insurance as this is hit deep to center field? Could it be? It is gone. Straightaway center. Broadway bomb. I believe this is number 42 of the season. He hit one while we were simming forward earlier. And he goes deep again. So we had one early on in the episode at Wrigley Field. Now you've got one right here in San Francisco as he goes dead center field for the Broadway bomb and gives his team an insurance run. Will they win the game? Yes, they do. They take it 5-3 and continue rolling on here with the division lead, looking like they're a lock now to not only be in the playoffs but take the division. As we reset things here towards the end of September, we'll probably do some more simming as we're now 9 games up in the division and all but a lock to take it. We'll see you next time for more Joe Broadway.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!